evening, families, faculty and staff, superintendent schedule, former school committee member, Pat Scherer, and of course, sixth grade graduates. It is my pleasure and honor to welcome you to the Northfield Elementary School graduation ceremony for the class of 2021. Before we begin, I would like to take a moment to thank Mrs. Hansel, Mrs. Porter, Mrs. Barstow, and Ms. Snedeker for planning and prepping our sixth graders for tonight's ceremony. I'd also like to thank our custodial staff, Nate Carlson, Mike Pacini, Sean Martineau, Kevin Seaman, and retired Peter Blake for helping with preparations. Give a wave to Peter Blake in the back. And thanks to Bridget Hammond for her work with the administrative tasks. Lastly, I would like to recognize the contributions of our PTO and parent volunteers, along with many staff members, for helping to set up and decorate to make this a special evening for you and your children. Please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. I am so grateful to be here tonight with all of you. This is the first gathering we have had at Northfield Elementary School since the winter family dance in January 2020. And the fact that it's to celebrate this milestone in your children's lives makes it an extra special first gathering. We actually had a rehearsal this morning with our student body, and it was the first time we were all together, and it was pretty powerful. We are happy to be back in this space. The past year has been hard, harder than any of us could have predicted 15 months ago, harder for our students, our teachers, and our families, hard in many ways and for many different reasons. Sixth graders, the past spring of your fifth grade year was interrupted abruptly by the pandemic. You then moved through your sixth grade year, spending far too much time staring at the screen while in the hybrid model, then remote, then hybrid again, until finally in April, we were able to come back to full in-person, at which point we started to experience a bit of normalcy. We can acknowledge there were a variety of challenges this past year, acknowledge that there were some disappointments, acknowledge that you did not get a regular, normal sixth grade year. But I would also invite you to consider what you have learned and gained from this year's experience. I believe you have learned how to work through challenging situations. You've learned how to accept disappointment, how to work in a remote environment. You've learned a whole lot about technology and Google Classroom and muting and unmuting and presenting and pinning and much more. You learned what 6 foot distancing feels like. You learned to tolerate wearing a mask for much of the day, and many adults didn't think that you'd be able to do that. You learned how to eat quietly in the cafeteria at your own small table. This year you learned to adapt and be flexible. You learned to overcome these obstacles. You learned to be more independent and self-sufficient learners. A sixth grade graduation ceremony is not only about the sixth grade year. Let's not let these challenges of the past year define your whole elementary school experience. The ceremony gives you and your families an opportunity to reflect on the years gone by, celebrate your growth and accomplishments thus far, and consider the future that awaits. This chapter of your lives is ending and a new one beginning. Your experiences here with us have played a significant role in shaping who you are today. Each teacher here, Each adult here has been a part of your life, has cared about you and for you, and has guided you to learn and grow in leaps and bounds. This morning we had sixth graders over here and preschoolers coming in, and the stark difference between their years potentially here as a preschooler and sixth grade, we could see it right in front of our eyes. We hope that you hold on to all that you have gained during your elementary years and carry it with you into middle school, high school, and beyond. I'd like to take a moment, so bear with me. Educators are, you know, famous for reading books. So I'd like to read a short story for you, to you. It's called I Wish You More. I wish you more ups than downs. I wish you more give than take. I wish you more tippy toes than deep. I wish you more we than me. I wish you more hugs than uggs. I wish you more woohoo than whoa. I wish you more will than hill. I wish you more can than not. I wish you more snowflakes than tongue. I wish you more pause than fast forward. I wish you more umbrella than rain. I wish you more bubbles than bath. I wish you more treasures than pockets. I wish you more stories than stars. I wish all of this for you because you are everything I could wish for and more. I am sure I can speak. Thank you. I am sure I can speak for all of us when I say that we will miss you. We wish you the very best. And we hope that you will look back at your time at Northfield Elementary School with the fondest of memories. Thank you. We will now hear from some of our sixth graders who will share their reflections about elementary school with you.
For my time in elementary school because I enjoy learning and talking to my classmates.
My favorite elementary school memory is a fourth grade field trip to Northfield Mountain. We went snowshoeing and learned about animals.
Elementary school has helped me overcome some of my fears.
Nice job. Sorry, Cole.
I'm thankful for all the teachers that have helped me throughout the years.
Elementary school has helped me overcome being shy and speaking in front of people.
Elementary school has helped me overcome being shy.
Good job.
Elementary school has taught me that I like to be independent, but I also like to have my friends by my side.
And I'd like to invite, oh, sorry, you want to do your thing first. Do you want to signal them? Sorry, oh, I guess Layla's not there. And I'd like to invite Ms. Hansel up to speak.
I'll be right here. Thank you. Apparently, I can't speak unless I can also see. Okay, so hello everyone. For those who may not know me, I'm Lynn Hansel, one of the sixth grade teachers here at Northfield Elementary School, and I definitely feel that I'm speaking on behalf of pretty much all the teachers and staff here. It's my pleasure to be here speaking this evening to all of you and to all of this year's sixth grade graduates. How lucky you graduates have been to have had NES and the rest of your community in your lives. How lucky we have been to have you in ours. You're an outstanding group of young people. Many of you have known each other since preschool, and all of you have formed special friendships and bonds that will last beyond the end of elementary school. Some will even last the rest of your lives. That group energy that you have when you are together is remarkable. Every single adult who has worked with you in specials, in their classrooms, and elsewhere in the school in the school comments all the time about what a great group of kids you are. You're fun, bright, cooperative, collaborative, funny, athletic, hardworking, and just great to spend time with. As sixth grade teachers, we receive the benefit of the love and hard work of your families, coaches, and so many of the other teachers and staff who have worked with you up to this point. It is the community that you see before you who helped get you to where you are today. Please, sixth graders, give them your applause and appreciation. But let's talk for a minute about this year. What a year, right? Actually, what a 15 months. The pandemic has brought out of each of us ways of functioning that we never thought we would ever have to do or ever thought that we could do. The end of last year was sudden and abrupt. You switched to fully remote learning at home and you never saw each other in person for months. You had to adjust to attending school on a Google Meet and doing assignments through Google Classroom. Your teachers had to remind you to turn your camera on. You had to tackle Wi-Fi issues and computer glitches. You had packet pickups and drop-offs. You attended beeping parades. You had to wear masks in public. You made the best of a bad situation. Because of it, you became experts in technology, time management, and found ways to have fun even when you weren't together. You carried on thinking and hoping that life would be normal by the fall. As we all know, that is not how it played out. Whereas last year was shocking and abrupt, this year was a series of ever-evolving changes and adjustments. Some of you were fully remote, while others were in special populations. All of you are special, by the way. We had simultaneous online and in-person learning. You became Cohort A and Cohort B. You had to bring all of your school things and your Chromebooks back and forth on alternate days. One cohort never saw the other in person. There were more packet pickups and drop-offs. Because of this, you furthered your expertise in technology. You continued to join a Google Meet every day, and now you had breakout rooms for small groups. You worked collaboratively on Google Docs and Google Slides, shared your screens, and played Pictionary on Jamboard. You further improved your organizational skills to keep track of your many necessary belongings, and you had to perfect your time management. Were you home today or at school? A lot of you also got to visit your refrigerators more often. In addition to all of this, you're a group of sixth graders who only once before in elementary school were separated into two different classes. As I mentioned before, you are a close group, not used to being split up anyway. And here you were in two different classes, most of you at home juggling all of this, and half of you with a brand new to NES teacher to boot. Who was this lady anyway? Amazingly, you all continued to grow and learn. Eventually and thankfully, all students were able to come back into the building and learn in person with your teachers, to see each other and be with your friends, kind of. You still had constant reminders to follow proper safety guidelines. 6 feet, you need to be 6 feet apart. Don't forget to sanitize. Did you sanitize on the way in? Pull your mask up. Yes, over your nose. Sorry, no, you can't sit that close together. Boy, did that get old for all of you and also all of us. What a year. Switching gears for a minute and try to stay with me here. Many of you know that yesterday's Spirit Week theme was Sports Day. I celebrated it by remembering the Greenfield Light Life Triathlon that I competed in twice a few years back. Yesterday, I dressed in my swimming gear, then my biking gear, and then my running gear over the course of the day. When I pulled out the medals I had for completing the event, not for placing in it, I saw on them the slogan, "To finish is to win." That really spoke to me. Some people choose to compete in the triathlon as a team. One person will swim, the next will bike, the third will run. It takes a team to get to the end, and each person does what they're best at to get there. It's like working together on a group project, even when you are 6 feet apart or online in separate houses. Each person contributes their best to the final product. Other people choose to compete the triathlon individually. They do all three events themselves. Having chose this option myself, I can tell you that I was stronger in some events than others, but I still wanted to do them all and have that sense of accomplishment at the end. I had to train extra hard in my weaker events in order to prepare, and even had some coaching from people who were better than me. It's like being a student and knowing that I'm better in math and reading than at spelling and writing, so I work extra hard and ask for help for the things I know I need to work on the most. In a triathlon, the swim is first because, well, frankly, they're afraid people will drown if they put that event at the end when the athletes are exhausted. It would have been so nice to swim last when I was hot, it was August, and needed invigoration, but no, the order is swim, bike, run. I'm here to tell you, there's nothing harder than getting off a bike after 15 miles, putting on running shoes, and slogging through a 3 mile run, which on its own would have been easy, and trying to make it to the finish line. Suddenly you're moving in slow motion with lead feet. After what seems like an eternity, you see the banner at the end and you're buoyed by the people on both sides of the road cheering you on. Well, do I need to finish the analogy? I will anyway. You sixth graders have been in a sort of triathlon of your own. You went from the sudden splash of the cold water last year where you had to either sink or swim, to this year pedaling, coasting, pumping uphill and gliding downhill. And finally, these past couple of weeks, to the hard run to the end, when you just wanted to be done already. You're about to cross the finish line, and you're doing so with your heads up, with respect for each other, with joy in your hearts and your eyes to the future. You're doing so with all these people in this beautiful community cheering you on and watching you go. To finish is to win, and you have won. Congratulations, sixth graders, you've made it. Best wishes from all of us at NES and all your family members who are cheering you on. You're off to middle school to accomplish more amazing things, and we can't wait to see what you do. Thank you.
We didn't get enough practice. So we will now hear some more reflections.
My favorite elementary school memory is making friends.
My favorite elementary school memory is when I went to Boston with Stemrys.
Yes. Elementary school has helped me overcome my fear of testing.
You got it, Cooper. Do you want me to hold this?
Yes.
All right,
team. I'm thankful for my time in elementary school.
You got it.
You can do it. Come on, you can do it.
In elementary school because...
You got it.
I have made friends who not only listen to me, but also have helped me.
Awesome.
Nice.
Elementary school has taught me that no matter where you are, you're never alone. You will always have friends and family sticking by your side.
Elementary school has helped me love reading and other ELA subjects.
My favorite elementary school memory was going rafting with the class.
And next, we will hear a piece from the NES band. They've been working remotely most of the year, although you wouldn't know that listening to them. A credit to Ms. Snedeker and all the hard work of her students. Our band students will play Sawmill Creek by Bruce Pearson. We will now hear the rest of our reflections.
My favorite elementary school memory is when in third and fourth grade we went to Lowell and dressed up as old-fashioned people.
My favorite elementary school memory is going rafting with all my friends and getting soaked with water.
Sorry.
My favorite elementary school memory is rafting.
Elementary school has helped me overcome many of things, such as rushing on work, saying S sounds, and holding a pencil.
I am thankful for the teachers, the library, and the art class at NES.
My favorite elementary school memories are playing soccer every recess with my friends.
I'm thankful for Mrs. Porter for making everything fun, such as field day, spirit week, rafting, etc.
Elementary school has helped me overcome my fear of speaking in front of people.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Stephanie Barstow. I'm the new music teacher here at NES. Tonight's class song is a little different than probably what you have seen in past years. Because of COVID guidelines, we actually could not sing in school for the majority of the year. So these guys decided to do a bucket drumming song. And they actually chose to do We Are the Champions by Queen, which is actually a very tricky song to bucket drum to. And they have done a phenomenal job. They have been an outstanding class. I've never had a class this well behaved ever in 11 years of teaching. To walk into a classroom and have it just be quiet for 40 minutes, I wasn't even sure what to do. I had to come up with more material for them to do because I didn't have to spend the whole time telling them to stop talking. And on top of that, they're just really kind. They're kind and they're patient and they're caring. And they were kind to me when my technology didn't work. And I just so appreciate them. We're gonna do it. Relax, take a breath. It'll all be good.
Paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime, and bad mistakes I've made a few. Thank you.
Excellent job. I would like to welcome former school committee member Pat Scherer to speak. She will be presenting the Charles Hand Math Awards tonight.
This is such a fun time when we see all our kids finishing up this sixth grade experience and we can all join with them. It's just makes me happy to be here. Several years ago, the Pioneer School Committee began this award to honor and remember an outstanding member who had passed. Charles Hand moved to Bernardston after he retired as a teacher, a math teacher, a principal, and a school superintendent, and that was all done in New Hampshire. So he decided to come to Massachusetts, which was a smart play for us and for him. He soon tired of retirement and joined our school committee, which was wonderful to have an experienced person that could help guide us. With his background as a math teacher, we found it fitting to set up this award to honor the outstanding math students as they graduate from our district's elementary schools. We also remember the fun person he was. He would never come to a school committee meeting unless he knew there was going to be cookies there. No cookies, no Charles. So as a treat for these three students that are going to be awarded this honor, we have cookies. A cookie, a huge cookie. I want to make a bigger one, but my dough ran out. So sorry, guys. So I will name these three students and they can come up and grab their cookies and their certificate. The first one we have is Layla Goldston. Goldston? Sorry, Goldston. Sorry, Layla. And I spelled your name wrong and I'm sorry. It's the cookie that makes a difference, right? Okay, sounds good. The next one is Abigail Mikulski. Did I mangle that too? There you go, Abigail.
Thank you.
Good job. Enjoy. Now, who is going to be number three? Look around. Are we right or are we wrong? How about Colin? Hey, you guys were great.
Thank you,
Colin. Congratulations. You guys are going to have so much fun in your further education. Just hang in there. It sounds like you're a great group of kids. So congratulations.
We are shortly moving towards diplomas and the big moment. Before we do that, could I invite a couple of friends up for just a moment that might have something special to deliver?
So this is just a small sign of this their students' affection towards them. They have nothing but wonderful things to say about their teachers. And I can tell you that students and staff have nothing but the best to say about our principal, who is phenomenal.
So, after we do diplomas, we are going to have the recessional down the middle. And as each student leaves, we would invite the families to join them to exit to your cars so that we can start the parade. So after everybody's off and running, we'll have a signal for the cars to go ahead and get started. You'll go through the bus loop first and then onto Main Street. And hopefully there'll be some people out. I know it's not a nice sunny night, but hopefully there'll be a few people out to cheer you on. So without further ado. Layla Boyden. Layla? Oh, sorry. Oh, we have too many Layla. We're going to scratch that. We're going to start again. Layla Boyden. Woo! Macy Buxton. Isabella Douglas, Bella. Cole Gamash. Julian Garza.
To go.
Abigail Gonzalez. Layla Goulston. Ren Gradoya. Layla Hammond. Callie Kratz. Cooper Ledger. Tad Loud. Kaylin Lupien. Jacob McFarlane. Abigail McCaskey. Dakota Peckham. Natalie Rios. Oh. Tia Strisky. Evan Tippenuk. Brody, welcome. Colin Woodward. And last but not least, Ava Warden. We now present to you the NES Class of 2021. Sorry, Ava.